Welcome to the University of Michigan Dentistry Podcast Series, promoting oral health care worldwide.
It's hard with the air. Get closer if you can. When you hold the diamond like this and bury it right to the shank, you will see that the cut is pretty well self-limiting. And we will take this diamond into the interproximal as far as we can go without nicking the adjacent teeth. They will make a cut halfway through the tooth in this area. Again, taking it interproximally, and then one near the incisal. Okay. Now we'll make our vertical cut. And then we will come through the incisal edge, the full depth of the diameter of the diamond, and then we'll make another vertical cut. And then bury this again, the full depth of our diamond. Now you can also take this round burr and use it to open up the embrasure slightly, and we will do this. The same diamond. Open up the embrasure on each side of the tooth. Now we will start by reducing the incisal portion. By cutting the little islands away. Bringing this into the interproximal. Now you'll notice here, if we can get a profile shot of this, that this will be done in two planes. This is the incisal cut, and then the cervical cut will be in this plane, because that labial surface of the tooth is curved. So it'll be this type of cut, and then this type of cut, and that'll maintain that curved surface. Okay. Now with this diamond, without touching the adjacent tooth, you can bring this reduction into the interproximal area without scarring the adjacent tooth. And this will then allow an adequate thickness of porcelain into the interproximal. With the same diamond then, this incisal can be reduced. And we just take the incisal down to the depth of our tracer cut. Now we'll make a finishing line at the lingual surface that we're going to change to a chamfer in just a moment. And this finishing line will be brought out into the interproximal, so we have kind of a modified slice that will go into our labial shoulder. This is brought into the interproximal. something here. We drag the Weedlestaedt in a backwards motion across this labial surface. And you can see that we will make then this slight bevel, just breaking the corner and making a slight finishing line that's quite sharp that will show on the die, and a lab man will know where to end the finishing line. And I'll also do it in this area. Just break that so we have a slight 45 degree bevel, and that bevel is brought into the interproximal to the slice that we have made. You can make this same finishing line with this file by holding the instrument along the axis of the tooth and using the adjacent tooth as an anchor. You can file this labial portion of the tooth and again make a very smooth bevel here so that there's a very definite sharp finishing line. There's no question when the laboratory looks at your die where the finishing line is.
You've been listening to a presentation from the University of Michigan School of Dentistry, which is dedicated to supporting open learning and open educational resources. This recording is licensed under the Creative Commons. It may be reused and redistributed for nonprofit use. Please attribute materials to the University of Michigan School of Dentistry and redistribute under this same license. For more information on how this and other University of Michigan School of Dentistry recordings may be used, visit www.dent.umich.edu/license.